Hello everyone, welcome to JCE Connect. So in this class we'll continue with the classifications of construction equipments. So in the previous class we have finished bulldozers and then scrapers, and in this class we'll study with the remaining equipments, that is power shovel, hoe, drag line and then clamshell. So power shovel. So power shovel, which is used in the preliminary to excavate the earth of all the classes except rock and to load it into bale guns. Okay. So here power shovel is nothing but this is also an earth moving or earth excavating equipment. So by using this power shovel, you can see in the image, so it can easily dig or excavate the earth by using this deeper stick, and by using the same instrument it can even load that whatever the earth materials are there to the wagons. Wagons are nothing but the transporting vehicles, so that it can move the earth surfaces from one place to other place. So here power shovel mounted on a traveler tracks, and so they are stable and can move at low speeds. So here, which is moves with the traveler mounted. So in the previous class I discussed about how exactly the traveler mounted as well as the wheel mounted equipments will works in the different areas, and here power shovel is also mounted on the traveler so that it can move at any type of soil, and but here by using this traveler mounted, that speed of equipment will be reduces. Okay, so it can move with the low speeds. The main advantage of this power shovel is, so it can excavate earth of all the classes except hard rock. I mean in the rock areas, I mean in the hilly rock areas and all, which is very difficult by using this power shovel. So except that rock, it can use in all the types of earth so that it can excavate and it can dump the soil from one place to other place. And this is how this power shovel will looks like. Okay, so which is there with the traveler mounted. So here you can see this is purely the traveler mounted. Okay, and then moving on to the next type of earth moving equipment, that is hoe. So hoe is an excavating equipment of the power shovel family. So again it looks like the power shovel only, but it is having the different advantages, and it is just differ than power shovel. So hoe is meant to excavate below the natural surfaces. For example, if we want to dig the earth surfaces which is lower than the ground level, so that time this hoe will use in much better aspects compared to the other types of the equipment. So here excavate the below the natural surfaces where the machine is stationed and is capable of having precise control the depth of the excavation at the close range work. So there in some cases this is a smaller equipment compared to other one, so that whatever the load of and weight of this equipment can bear on that particular earth area, so it will be less, so that it can easily move at the shorter distances and it can get works out. Okay, and next type, that is drag line. So before this, just we'll watch a few video clips about power shovel as well as the hoe. And here this is belongs to power shovels. So how exactly it has manufactured and how exactly it is used in the computer. So this is purely related with the traveler mounted. So here you can see this. So this is that traveler mounted, how exactly it moves by using this system. Okay. Here you can see this is rotating triangular rocker, okay. And it is having bucket cylinders which is attached to the tri power rockers, so everything which is works with the hydraulic pressures. And here you can see this is boom cylinder which is attached to the tri power rocker, so these rockers will works with the hydraulic pressures. Everything which is with the traveler mounted, as I have told. So as I told, this is with the traveler mounted. Okay, this equipment works with the traveler mounted, and here you can see during this particular height, during the lifting of this equipment, this bucket remains as the constant angle, whatever you can see here. So it, this is with a constant angle so that it won't disturb with the buckets at a certain height, and only boom cylinders are hydraulically charged. So here boom cylinders will be there, so this particular system, what you can see, this is boom cylinder, so that it is hydraulically charged. With a single button it can lift that earth from one place to other place. And then to all hydraulic pumps supply boom functions only, boomer functions only. So it's nothing but what? So within these hydraulic pumps they have placed whatever it is highlighting, so it can work based upon this. This is simplified operation, just with automatic system it can work. And constant boom momentum, so while lifting the earth from lower line to the higher line, so which will remains constant. So here you can see in general, so which remains constant so that it won't get disturbed with the earth surface, whatever which is present in this bucket. And again it balances the loss of hydraulic pressure. And then during the lift, this transfers or speaking the gravitational force, that one also it can get, and it creates the supporting boom momentum in addition to the hydraulic momentum. And this during the lift, that allows the smaller boom cylinders for faster lifting speeds. So when we want to carry out the faster works, then it gets done. And it eliminates the need of react, and it sticks with the original position. Okay, and here the rollback limiter. So it can during the lift, with all the cylinders fully extended, the bucket remains in a safe position at a maximum height. So here you can see the particular height of this equipment from this place to total the ground area. So it can move with a maximum height with a extended bucket like systems. Okay. And automatically it reduces the risk of material slippage over the bucket back wall. And then the main advantage is it enhances the safety, so no other accident will take place when we have used these types of systems in the construction industry. It's having simplified the operation by automatic bucket guidance. Just we need to write the program, and depends upon that it will get works out and increases productivity with constant boom momentum, and it enhanced safety via rollback limiter. So this is application of flow, that how exactly it uses the earth surfaces and then it stores at the required location. So it will show us activity part of the small. You can see this, how exactly it is between that specified earth or whatever the soil to other end. Okay, so this is specially used in the part where the ground level is naturally lower than the original. The total excavated area is just to get the ground level. So in that case, it's okay to increase the excavation. So this is how exactly it works. So here you can see, so how exactly this hole will get works out. So you can see the original ground level here, and if anything it want to dig or shift from one place to other place, you can use these types of hole in the construction. Okay. So usually by comparing the ground level, so if soil material is or excavating material is lower than the ground level, then that time these types of equipment that is the spoon might easily move, it can easily box out. Finally it loads at the beginning and then it makes it wrong. So now moving on to the next type of equipment, that is dragline. So dragline is used to excavate the soft earth and to deposit in nearby banks or to load into wagons. So this is also earth excavating equipment, so specially used to excavate the soft earth. Soft earth in the sense where the loose materials of soil can be there, no? So there it can drag and just it can dig the surface and then it can load to the required location, okay? Or else just it can load that one to the trucks or wagons. And here drag line may be mounted on a graveler track. So here also these drag lines are seen in most of the cases with a graveler mounted, so that it can move at any type of soil or earth surfaces. And third point, so here the bucket is thrown out from the drag line on the top of the earth and then it will be excavated and then pulled back towards the base of the machine. So here how exactly it can dig and it can get the earth surfaces from one place to other place. So here it consisting of the bucket like structures. So you can see in the image here. So here it can see the drag line bucket or here it is. Okay, so here you can see the drag lines. Okay, so drag line buckets. So this consisting, okay, so this particular bucket, it see through by using this ropes, I mean that cables, at the required location, and then this particular bucket, it is going to drag this particular earth surfaces and then it can store to the required wagons. Okay, so this drag line cable, it can move, I mean it can get operate by using this system, I mean by using this chamber. Okay, so this particular drag line which will get thrown to the required location, and then so this particular area it gets start drags from one location to other location, and then this bucket it is going to thrown, and then it stores the soil materials and then it dumps at the required wagons. Okay, and now we'll see how exactly this drag lines will works out. So especially these types of the drag lines are used in the river banks and all, so we'll see how exactly this one will get works out. Yeah. Works out. And now moving on to the next type of earth excavating equipment, that is clamshell. So clamshell is consisting of heavy buckets of two hulls in the form of a shell that is hinged together at the top. So this is the bucket like structures, but here it can carry with two closed buckets. So here the bucket systems it can carry at the time of the excavation, and then it can store by closing those two different holes. So here you can see that one, and here the shells may be attached to the shovel crane, that is shovel crane unit what we can call, or even at the boom of the drag line. So here it's like the two bucket like system what you can see in the system, right? So this particular two different holes, one is here and second one is here. So just it will thrown at the required location, and these two different holes or buckets are going to carry out the soil in the closed system. Okay, so okay, and here the shell may be attached to the shovel crane unit or at the bottom of the drag line. So again, that is depends upon the different types of equipments what we have used there. I mean different companies. So one is attached with a shovel crane unit, or one other types of the equipments they are attached with a boom of drag line. And here the open clamshell bucket is thrown on the top of the loose material soil, and then after the material is dug, and as the bucket is lifted, the two holes closes, entrapping the material into the bucket. So initially, while throwing the bucket on the loose surfaces, I mean especially these types of the equipments are used in the loose surfaces only. So that time, initially they will throw that one with a open bucket-like systems, and when it falls on that loose soil, and then it closes and store the materials within that closed bucket-like system. And here, the equipment is useful for the excavation of loose materials at or below the existing ground surfaces. Okay, and these are the different types of the clamshells what you have seen, and we saw a small video clip that how exactly it will get works out.